After the discovery of how to make glass, the most important development in the history of glass was the discovery of glass blowing, because this meant that for the first time, glass could be produced in large quantities, in a great variety of shapes and sizes, and glass suddenly became a very useful object as well as a luxurious object. And this development took place somewhere in the Eastern Mediterranean 50 or 75 years before the birth of Jesus.
Glass is gathered on the end of a metal blowpipe. And then rolled back and forth on a metal plate called a marver. This makes the glass perfectly round and concentric with the blowpipe. Then, air is blown into the pipe to create a bubble. As the tip of the vessel, the bottom of the vessel needs to be thick. It's rolled on the marver again to cool it, and after a brief reheating and yet another marvering of the tip, the initial bubble is blown larger and immediately stretched to become a tube. A third blow, after the neck has cooled, blows the vessel body to its full size. A constriction is made near the blowpipe, and the bottom is flattened. Next, the pontle must be added. The pontle is a metal rod with a little bit of hot glass on the tip that's used as a handle to allow the worker to hold the vessel from its bottom while reheating and reshaping its opening. A little bit of water dripped on the tube with a little mechanical shock breaks easily. Now the edge is reheated to a temperature at which it gets slightly soft. A conical tool is used to push in and fold the edge. After a final reheat, the two-bladed tool known as the jacks are used to give the opening its final shape. A soft tap on the metal rod breaks the vessel free of its punty. Roman workers 2,000 years ago created endless numbers of vessels this very same way.